Whoosh! What's up, crew? Welcome to an update video. I wanted to jump on really quickly just to let you know what's going on at the moment. Haven't really been posting too much, and the ones that I have posted have been catch-up vlogs, and the next one is going to be, you know, my trip to Hawaii, which has a lot of footage. I got started on it and sort of started to take too long, or I was playing with too many little clips here and there, so I'm taking a break. And then in between that and life, I have some client work that I needed to do, and when I hop on to do that, my computer right now is so mad at me, it's not even funny. So I have this wedding, and I shot way too much footage, all of it's in 4K, and my machine is just not capable of editing 4K footage right now. I condensed their ceremony, and I'm currently editing out 20 minutes of it so that I can do it in chunks. It's taking an hour or so. So whenever something like this is exporting, I'm not able to do anything else really. If I use the internet, if I watch YouTube videos or anything on my computer, it slows down the export. So I have to take myself away from that. So that obviously doesn't allow me to edit very much for my YouTube channel, which kind of sucks. At the end of the year, I'm looking to potentially upgrade my computer depending on where I'm at financially. And I've been researching the possibility of doing a desktop only because I hear so many good things, and you don't have to spend as much money to have a powerful machine as you do for Mac. Mac, I think the base price for something powerful for video editing for 4K footage is $4,000. And for a computer, a desktop PC is gonna be more like 2,000, if that. That's where I'm at as far as video editing. And then if I know that I'm not gonna be able to have time for editing, I don't really shoot much. So hopefully this will take me absolutely no time to edit. I just wanted to jump on, let you guys know what's going on. I've got a lot of this type of stuff to do really quick for them, as I'm trying to build an understanding of what I can offer, and also understand what I need to do next time to do it more efficiently. I should probably have a third camera going that is literally shooting at 1080, 50 megabits per second, 24 frames per second, and not a lot of people usually get that, I don't think, but it requires so much, and it's still gonna be higher quality than what it was back in the day when some guy shot it on a VHS tape. But anyways, that's probably stuff you don't really mind to hear about, so moving on. I'm gonna jump into a workout. I'm just gonna leave my camera away so I can get it done quickly, because it is 4 p.m. and I gotta go pick up Dylan. Gonna get that workout done, go pick up Dylan, and that will be the end of it. So once this is done, the wedding stuff, because there's a lot to export, I do have a client tomorrow that I'm shooting for. I'm pretty excited because I get to use the Hold Fast Gear harness for my two cameras. I'll have my A7 R3, which is what I'm using right now on this side, and my A6500 on the other side. And I'm gonna be getting footage for a catering company, and they're catering for Google. So that's kind of cool. So if I ever get a chance to pick up the camera and be like, hey, what's up? I'll do it. And then at some point, I'll probably make another sort of catch up vlog to that point. And then I get next week, and then I'm heading to the games. So there you go, quick little update. If you're new, subscribe. If you're not new, tap and go that like button. Leave a comment, share this video. Those are things that help grow the crew. Until the next one, I'll see you later, crew.